Hi, to begin your Afghan, we're going to make sure you got the supplies that you need. You will want to get 5 skeins of yarn. I get the red heart yarn. What I'm going to be using for the new one is a sea coral collar. It's the exact same brand that I got to make the gray one, which is shown in the directions. You will want to make sure that you get the ones that's 482 yards. You will need 5 of these. Or comparison, if you can't find the big super saver size, you could get maybe 10 of the regular size, and that's going to make your Afghan for you. You will need a size 8 millimeter needle, and you will also need a yarn needle and a pair of scissors. Okay, to begin, you're going to be wrapping your needle and making a loop and tying it. I always have a little extra at the end, so as I'm crocheting, I can tuck that in later and it tucks in very nicely. Now, to begin, you want to make your chains. In the pattern that I will be sharing, I will tell you exactly how many chains to make for your 6 foot by 4 foot Afghan, but for this example, I will not be doing that many chains, obviously. So to make a chain, you will wrap and pull in, wrap and pull in through the hole, wrap and pull in through the hole, wrap, pull, wrap and pull, wrap and pull, wrap and pull, wrap, pull, wrap, pull through the hole, wrap and pull through the hole, wrap and pull down through the hole, wrap, pull down through the hole. As you can see, it's making a row of chains, which is exactly what you want. Now, when you're done with whatever length that you decide to go to make your Afghan, a lot of people use craft clips or yarn clips at the end so they can mark where each row begins and ends. I don't feel that's necessary, but I mean, that's your preference. I do not choose to do that. But at the very end of your row, you would then chain 2, 1, 2. Now you'll count back, 1, 2, 3. So you go in 1, 2, 3. In the third one back, you want to, before you go in, you want to wrap your needle, go in that third chain, wrap, bring through, wrap again, and then pull that string through all of them. There should be 4 that you're pulling it through. And the first couple times it's going to be a little rough to pull it all through, but it'll get through and it'll get easier, trust me. You'll want to wrap, go down through the next chain, wrap, wrap, and again pull through all 4 of them like that. You want to wrap, go into the next chain, as you can see, the next chain hole, wrap and pull through all 4, wrap, go down through your next chain, see, your next chain hole, which is right there. You'll want to go in,
I've been listening to your neighbor, Ray Jacobs, and his daughter, Amanda. Do you know when I can reach that?
Oh, dear. I'm afraid Ray is not coming back. He passed away a couple of days ago in a terrible car accident.
Was his daughter in this?
No, thank the Lord. But that doesn't mean she isn't hurting. No, the good doctor is doing everything he can.
Well,
You keep going down through each one. So it should look something like this as you're working. All right. Now, I'm going to finish off the row while I let you finish off the row. If you hear the TV in the background, I always need to have some form of background noise. If it's not the TV, it's a radio, music playing, something. I just like something to have as a little bit of background noise. Like I said, the first time you do it with a thicker needle, if you're not used to working with thicker needles, it will be a little difficult. Trust me, it will loosen up for you as you go down through. The very first row that you do is pretty difficult to do, but it does get easier. And it's super easy to do, as you will see as we go along.